black men is try to elevate themselves. Mm-hmm. And when I see a lot of the young men now, the way that they portray themselves, mm-hmm. and the way that they're acting, you know, it disheartens me. Mm-hmm. And I am glad to see that you are taking a stand and a step to try to improve that image of the young black men.
I appreciate you, brother. And you know what I always say? What I hate is you can hear a verse in a rap song nowadays. And in that verse, the brother says, I sold 2 keys of cocaine. And in the second verse, you hear him, he probably killed 3 or 4 people. And then later, he goes to the strip club.
Yeah.
It don't happen like that. How are you going to do all this in one song and not catch any criminal charges? Who does that?
It's that world.
Yeah, it's that world. So, I mean, we got to make sure that we exhibit the right and true story, and not the false sense of reality. Dude, I'm not going to sit here and do all, you just saw what happened to me. I just did 17 years, and lo and behold, if it wasn't for the parole board feeling that I was a polished soul, they would have never let me go. Yes, sir.
I know it'll be a long answer, but that's succinct. What was it that, in your opinion, swayed the parole board life, brother in the South?
I know. It means life. And let me tell you what happened was, first and foremost, I know it was God that put the hand on them and said, you better do this.
Mm-hmm.
Second, they told me I was having a hearing after being turned down for parole like 6 times. And they said, no, finally, you're going to be in front of these people. I said, what? I'm going to be in front of them? And I went to my tomb. I went and wrote a 7-year business plan for my life.
Yeah.
And when they took me in front of that parole board, I laid that business plan out in front of them. And they said, what are you going to do if we let you go? I said, well, right here, if you have time to read it, we can. But in a nutshell, blah, 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 blah. Guess what? I've been home 7 years.
Wow.
And within each year, everything that was in that business plan was 7 years.
Yeah.
Any more questions? And if you want to get my business card for anything, I'm out here. I'm sorry, yes, ma'am.
Is the title of your book A Polished
Soul? It is. I have copies. Yeah, we're going on A Polished Soul all the way because
okay.
That's the whole concept.
And your foundation as well.
It's my nonprofit organization that does
there.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Any more questions? Yes, sir.
Are you still in North Carolina?
I am. I'm in the Raleigh-Durham area, but I do travel. I just got my passport, so I'm being pulled over to Africa real soon, seriously. So I mean, everything.
I'm going with
this is one of my film partners, great filmmaker as well, Edward Lewis, man. I love this brother to death.
Thank you.